Hello everybody, welcome back to Geoguessr. We're starting a bit different because once again being joined by somebody else. Hello Styles.
Hello everyone, tip scales, whatever.
Yes, that as well. Things are going to be a little bit different. This is not co-op, we're going head to head. Challenge is all set up. Let's kick the music and start challenge.
Okay, hit start challenge. Okay, this is... Already I don't know where I am.
It would be easy if you immediately knew where you were though.
Well, someone got a superpower where I could just go, aha, I know exactly where I am.
Yeah, it's called using Google, but you're not allowed to do that.
Or am I? No.
Well, I know what country we're in.
Oh, okay, well that van is... that van would seem to be stopped in the middle of the road. Ooh, a sign. What does the sign say? It's...
Okay, gibberish.
Yeah, let's go with that one.
It generally is.
Well, yeah, but it gives me a rough idea of where it might be.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, language is pretty important.
I mean, it gives me a greater understanding of the world where it is. So, yeah, my week's been rather boring, but, you know, gotta find ways to have fun. Command & Conquer Generals, for example.
Yeah, I've got my games as well. Finally got accredited or something on Keymailer, which took like 2 months. Oh, it usually takes a few days. 2 freaking months.
Ow. Did you get your money back? Or was it a good game?
It's kind of like a place where you can request Steam keys.
Okay.
And you're expected to do a video on it, of course.
I think it was 2 days ago or yesterday, the FTL forums were down for several hours.
Really?
Huh. Yeah, I was like, I have the FTL forums kind of bookmarked, so I know, you know, if a new mod comes out or something.
Well, I have them bookmarked too for the series, of course, but you know, we don't pay too much attention.
Right, so, yeah. I think my mouse might have flipped my view 180 degrees.
Keep an eye on your compass.
What, the thing is, I think I swore I saw that sign several times already.
For all you know, it might be just, there's a house here. Upcoming house.
Oh. I'm still looking at trees.
I've seen a few houses.
Oh, great, I'm back with that van again. Getting back to the start.
Well.
Wasn't that exciting? Ah, there's a farm.
Huzzah.
I go that way. I didn't. Or else that sign would be more visible. Okay, that sounds closer to something.
Ooh, something useful. Ah, never mind.
Let me guess, it wasn't meant to be.
No, it's like, hey, look, there's 2 town names. It's like 3 kilometers and 2 kilometers. That thing can be small as hell. Good luck trying to find that in a big country.
Oh.
Handy if you know what road you're on, but other than that, nope.
Nope. That's the thing about country roads, you don't know where you are. Then who's going to stop you driving at high speed?
Yeah, that's true. I don't know if it would be really smart to drive at high speeds here, though.
Well, apparently the Northern Territory in Australia has no speed limits on a lot of the roads, but...
Well, yeah, but the thing there is if you get off the road, you end up in the dusty field here, you smack against a tree.
Well, the thing is also, you probably don't want to drive at like 200 kilometers an hour on a gravel road.
No, you probably don't.
I was going to get in a lot of these police movies, police chases and stuff, is that, like, I remember years ago I watched this thing called World's Wildest Police Videos, the car would travel at really high speeds and the tires would start to pop.
Sure.
But isn't the thing about cars, though, is that the tires are rated for very, very high speeds.
Depends on the tire, if you get, like, a shitty tire, it'll...
Like retreads.
No.
Which is actually a thing that in the United States that retreads are actually kind of legal, whereas
yeah,
in
but
Australia,
you can only do it X amount of times, don't you? Like two or three times, and you have to toss it out anyway.
Yeah, well, the thing is, it's here in Australia that retreads are kind of illegal unless it's on trucks.
Yeah, I think it's the same thing here.
Because our trucks kind of need the retreads because, well, the tires aren't going to last long anyway.
Yeah.
Especially with the distances they're traveling. So, that's just the thing though, is you can't have retreads on cars. It's just not a, it's illegal to do so. They're a major hazard on when you're traveling at 100. When you're traveling at 100, their retreads are kind of rated for 80.
Damn.
If you're lucky.
If you're not, the whole thing just
pacing
explodes.
Pacing on tires on top of tires. Still have no idea. I should be putting my little marker.
Just make sure that there is a marker when the time runs out, otherwise you just put yourself up for a zero.
Oh, okay. I'll go with that one then. For the moment, while I continue down this country road. See how close we were to our destination. It'd be funny if it turns out it's all in South America.
Yeah, I'm fairly sure of the country, so I can guarantee it's not South Africa.
Or America. But it'd be funny if it was. It's like, we were both wrong because somehow...
There are instances where stuff like that happens. I mean, I was in a German school that ended up being in South Africa, like you mentioned it. Well, okay, 1 minute left and I finally find a road number. God damn. Okay.
Okay. The...
So this should be the start of it or something.
Oh, great. More signs that don't tell me what the roads are. Where villages might be.
Well, you usually don't have too much use out of villages if you don't know where you are to begin with, but...
Ooh, blue littered bin. That's interesting.
Really, though?
Well, over here we have the green lid. Well, it used to be the green lid, now it's red. For the general rubbish, and then you have the yellow littered one for recycling. Then you got the bright green one for plant matter.
We got green, and the rest is just plastic bags. Like blue plastic bags, yellow plastic bags.
Really? The dark green lid is what the standard wheelie bin is, because it's, unpainted. And time's run out, and it's... Okay, I was completely off.
I wasn't.
Okay, where'd you get?
I got Sweden. The first picture you saw, I turned around and looked at how she saw a Swedish flag.
Okay. Because no one else has guessed yet on my end.
No, because you guessed first.
Oh.
I'm already started the next one, by the way.
Okay, alright. Ooh, so that means I'm running out of time. Alright, so, you got signs here.
Yep.
But yeah, the, that gives me an idea. Alright, so,
That's a weird one.
Oh, one lost their tire. Well, instead of a retread. But yeah, over here, the wheelie bins are like dark green, so the ones with dark green lids are your general rubbish, but in recent years, people have been swapping them out for the red littered ones.
Okay.
Maybe because they got confused with light green. So, one of those lucky house owners that still has the green littered bin.
Well, we got, like I said before, proper green ones for, garden stuff and potato peels and whatever. And then yellow is your everyday stuff. And then there's blue for plastic bottles and soda cans.
Okay, recycling.
Yeah.
Although... Apparently aluminium is one thing you should always recycle.
Which is?
What I was saying, it's one thing because every other, like, a lot of other goods that you try and recycle, it's not, it's much cheaper or easier to dig them up and refine them than it is to recycle them. Whereas aluminium is much more efficient in that matter.
No. Have you seen the language in this place? What the hell kind of letters are those? It's like an upside down L.
I haven't seen any.
What does it even mean?
All I've seen so far in terms of signage is a 40-kilometer sign. I think I'm going the another way. I think I went the opposite way.
I'm going west.
Well, so am I, aren't I?
Well, the red points to the north, so.
Oh. Well, my red one is pointing.
Oh, then I'm going east, actually. No, wait. No, I'm going west. No, I'm right.
The red thing here looks like it's pointing west on my end. I don't know. Found a house.
Jeez. The language here is taken, really something special.
Hey, it was taken recently. It was taken this year. And the rest of the road since 2015. Yeah, that car's been... What the... I think I've been hitting the back button so much, it essentially just, you know... doesn't catch up for a while. And sets me back.
I have a vague idea where we are, but...
Don't share it!
Like... I'm split up between a few countries, let's put it that way.
Well, to me, it still has been narrowed down. I still think it's I'd say it's in one of the five continents. So I don't think it's in Australia, and I don't think it's in Antarctica.
Well, I hardly think it's America either.
Well, you never know. I did see a discarded tire.
Oh no, that's a dead giveaway.
Considering how America is with tires, probably is.
Yeah, but finding the language is proving more difficult than I hoped it would be.
Well, the sign indicates it's... Nope. Ooh, is that a billboard? Is that a billboard or a sign? It says...
There's that same thing again. And there's a freaking brimstone logo. What the hell is this place? Freaking
okay,
Satan worshippers?
Well, I don't know. Maybe it is.
Where the hell did they use a flipped over L?
I don't know. But I think I've narrowed it down. Well, I haven't narrowed it down, but I have seen a sign that gives me an idea of it may be on a continent.
Well,
a large continent.
Well, there aren't that many small ones to begin with.
That's true.
Ah.
Continent is kind of large. Then again, an island can be a continent.
Yeah.
Like Australia?
But it's not a continent on its own, is it? There's like a whole bunch of crud that goes along with it. Like New Zealand.
I don't know. I'm not exactly sure. Like, why does it count as a continent? Why is Europe and Asia separate continents even though they're the same landmass? Why is Africa a continent even though it's on the same landmass as Europe and Asia?
I don't know. You gotta split up somewhere. I mean, America is all interconnected as well.
Well, yeah. Then again, you could say they're no longer connected because of the Panama Canal or the Suez Canal. You know, those
they're,
two separate areas.
In that
areas.
Way, you'll have a hard time figuring out a single country that's completely connected to itself. Hey, there we go. We are...
Hey, I found a town.
Here?
It says... No. Same thing.
Damn.
Same thing I was...
But that's...
Then again, that's probably not a town name. It's a...
What? Here?
No. No, do you know any towns where you have a town sign and then when you're leaving the town has the same town sign but it's got a line through it?
Yeah. That's the same thing here. Oh, we do.
I didn't have that here. It's like, you know, you've got a big sign telling you where you're entering, but you don't say there's no sign saying you're leaving this town.
Well,
please come back.
usually the reason for it is because there's different speed limits inside the town and outside of the town. So knowing that you're leaving the town means you can speed up again.
I went for a long trip from Sydney to Brisbane. That's the main highway was out. The main freeway was out, so you had to go the long way through, and the speed limits would constantly change.
Yeah.
Along the side roads.
Yeah.
Like you'd be travelling at 100, then you enter a school zone.
Yeah.
And then once you're in a school zone, the
Well, there's the end of the timer.
Well, okay, I'm just.
Freaking Serbia?
Oh! My timer hasn't ended, you know.
Oh, I thought it did. Well, there you go. You have that one for free.
Ha 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 ha! Well, I've. Oh, wait. Oh, okay, yeah, all right.
Guess you beat me on that one, huh?
I just drew it randomly at Serbia. Alright, so start next round. We gotta do this on three.
Yeah.
Or is it before three or on three?
I'm already started.
Oh.
I'll just be a bit more.
Let's spoil it next time.
I thought we were somewhere on the same time or so. No, that's.
What's the thing? It doesn't actually tell you. Like I said, we should go on three.
Yeah. I'll just pay a bit more attention to flapping things out like that.
Yeah, I mean.
All right.
Holy crap! That's worse than the women floating in space.
Oh.
Well, that's good for me. It's like a weapon. It's like a weapon floating in space. Probably bad for you. That weapon could have been yours.
You know, I've played this longer, so I suppose it wouldn't be the worst thing to give you at least a little bit of an edge like that.
Although I'm still surprised at how Arnie stuff's figured out the strategy where. If you have an AI ship, just vent out the oxygen.
Enemies
will go try and find the nearest room without air. I thought they'd try and find the nearest system.
I thought so as well, but apparently not. I'm more interested in how the hell he managed to get a bomb to deplete his shield layer.
Wasn't it a bomb that sets things on fire?
So what does that? That doesn't change anything, does it? It's a bomb. It can't deplete a shield layer.
What kind of bomb was it?
Small bomb.
Small one?
Yeah.
The what?
Yes?
Well, the small bomb, doesn't the small bomb do 2 damage?
Yeah, but the shield system wasn't damaged, it was just a shield layer that went out.
Hmm. Okay. I have no idea then.
Apparently it has something to do with the Zoltan shield, like the bomb hit the Zoltan shield, but before it exploded, the Zoltan shield got taken out by a different shot, causing the bomb to hit the shield, but not the shield system.
Oh, okay. I thought the bomb would just, you know, sit at the edge and nothing would happen.
Yeah, I thought so as well, but there you go.
Learn new things every day. so that area even sold, has it? Nope, not gonna give you the name of the real estate agency? Fine. Don't mix blur with blur.
That'll work. Jeez, the weirdest things can get blurred out in this game. Like,
I think it's trying to hide license plates, and a road sign might count as a license plate.
Yeah, but why blur out half a billboard?
Like I'm saying, it's probably confuses it for a license plate. Computers, man.
Yeah, could be.
But I for one support our robot overlords.
I'm still a bit on the fence.
Did I say overlords? I meant protectors.
Of course you did.
Yeah, you heard that song?
No, I don't think I did.
Okay, it's Jonathan Coulson. It's Christmas on Chiron Beta Prime.
Okay.
Yeah, essentially, it is. You know, they're living in a mine with the robot overlords. Did I say overlords? I meant protectors. And they're a glowing red. They're a giant Santa Claus on every corner, and they're looking at you with the glowing red eyes. They know if you're bad or good.
Of course they would. Why the hell do I keep seeing the same?
No one is ever good, but everyone tries. And the dust outside the airlock shoots ammonia-scented snow.
Aww.
Tis
like
the season. Like a winter wonderland. Make it Soylent Green for a pie.
Aww. You can't complain at that point, you know? You gotta just
yeah,
like
do
that.
I love my Soylent Green. Mm-hmm. Although Soylent Green does vary from person to person.
different strokes for different folks, I suppose.
Yeah. Well, I'll stick with the slurm.
Not the super slurm.
Wham bam wham wazzle. Yep, still have no idea. These signs! Signs! Give me more info! Also, internet, load faster. Wow, I can get a helicopter. Great. Where's the helicopter place?
Yeah.
What is the helicopter place called?
Spotted numerous signs of that. It's like a helicopter with like a water landers or something under it.
Hmm. Yeah. I want to ride one of those. Actually, no, I think I've already have.
Really?
On a cruise. Yeah, I've been on a cruise and I went on a helicopter and I've been on a helicopter over Noumea. I think not Noumea. No, it was Port Vila.
Okay.
Then years ago, I went to the Great Barrier Reef and took a helicopter ride over that.
Cool.
Yeah, it looked like I only recorded my iPad though because I didn't have a camera at the time. It was after that trip I was like, I need a camera. Look at the surface of another planet when you put the camera over the Great Barrier Reef. It looks like the surface of the moon, but it's green.
Sure. The green moon.
That's just a huge coral reef we're looking at. Although apparently it's dying.
Really?
Yeah, the temperatures are rising and also ships are being sent out to dredge it further so bigger cargo ships can get to the harbour. Because, Great Barrier Reef is actually exactly what the name is. It's a Great Barrier.
Not for long.
Apparently. Exactly. So that's why we're digging through it. To allow big ships through to deliver more stuff in. We're not going to take it over by the air. Well, from what I heard, cargo freighters are very, very pollutive.
What, like by boat and stuff?
Yeah, cargo freighters use up a lot of fuel, and the trip they take to carry a load of cars from an overseas factory to the port. Apparently, they use up it burns a lot more carbon dioxide than those cars will ever do.
I know planes are bad, and so are trucks, but I mean. Boats and stuff, that's acceptable.
Well, they are essentially running on kerosene and petroleum and all that. They're not running on diesel, really.
Mm.
Plus, safety regulations and standards, because maritime law and stuff.
Well, 15
then again,
seconds left.
I'm only hearing this from an American perspective, so I wouldn't take it, I'd take it with a grain of salt. Definitely with a grain of salt.
Yeah, probably, yeah.
Alright, and timer's running out on my end. It's, completely and utterly wrong, right? Yeah. I had it originally somewhere in North America, then I decided, no, it's probably somewhere in Europe.
Yeah, I went with Quebec. The first sign I saw was a maple leaf. There was French, and it looked American. So, boom, Canada.
Wow.
Oh, great. Ready?
Right. Okay. Sorry, I took a caramel slice out of the fridge, and it's been sitting here for the last 20 minutes or so.
Okay.
It's melting. I can't really tell. Probably somewhere elsewhere.
Must be right.
Well, if it's not here, then it must be somewhere else. Great words to live by. Great words to live by the great Essie. Next to, people die when they are killed.
That they do.
And also, There are two times when the enemy will attack. When you're ready for him, and when you're not ready for him.
Yeah, I mean, it's like saying you only drink on two occasions, when it's raining and when it's not raining.
Well, what happens when an unstoppable object meets an immovable object?
It ricochets.
Price of vodka rises.
Or that, sure. I can see it happening.
Because, you know, because weird stuff happens and the price of vodka rises.
Where did you even get that idea from?
I think it's called Russian humor.
Okay, sure. Yeah. Whatever, yeah, right?
There's a whole article on TV tropes about it.
Yeah, but there are like so many of them.
Well, I have some idea where this might be.
Well, you may know more than I do.
Well, like I said, some idea. It's probably completely and utterly wrong. I might be on the wrong continent. I mean, I can only think of two continents. Well, this might be on, it turns out. Oh, wait, it's somewhere in Europe.
What? You think this is Europe?
No, I'm saying, no, as in, I've got two ideas where it might be, and it's going to be like, oh, wait, sorry, it was somewhere in Europe. You're just completely and utterly wrong. I'm like, ah!
I've had that happen a few times already.
Well, you know, the seed might decide it wants to do something bad about it, and then goes, oh, wait a minute, you know what, you're supposed to be elsewhere. And I'm like, what, really? remember that one?
Yeah.
Like, it's like we knew exactly where we were going to be, somewhere in Victoria, and then Gold Coast.
Not to mention the game glitching out and putting us in the same place twice, which it should.
Yes, I mean, yeah.
There's really not much out here, is there?
No, there isn't. I even look at a billboard. I mean, it really can't be in Europe, right?
Yeah, I suppose it still could be, but yeah.
I think even backwaters, country roads in Australia have billboards saying McDonald's next 5 kilometers. And then the Maccas will be on both sides of the road.
You're never more than 10 kilometers away from McDonald's. Hey.
Well. You're never 10 kilometers away from a fast food restaurant. At a petrol station. That's the important part as well. You've got to have a petrol station next to it.
Well, not too far from here. We've got 3 petrol stations over the course of 500 meters. Granted, it's next to an off-ramp from a highway, but still. Healthy competition, anyone?
Well, to me, I was actually riding to Penrith, I think, long distance from where I live. Mm-hmm. Although it's a longer distance than Parramatta from where I live, but Parramatta's more exhausting. But I was going to Penrith and I saw like several petrol stations along the route and route whatever. For some reason, I can't switch between route and route. There were several petrol stations along the road, and they're all owned by 7-Eleven.
Okay.
Which is, you know, reasonable.
Yeah, I guess.
And they're all selling Krispy Kreme donuts.
Cool.
Krispy Kreme donuts are not bad. They're actually, sorry, I wouldn't say not bad. They're really, really good. That's one of the reasons why I rode out to Penrith, because they still have a store there, which actually, well, it doesn't actually have the production line going on, but there's a store there that is an actual store, not just a stand or a tiny little cafe. It's a manufacturer. It's a manufactorium.
I don't know. Never
so they could
been
potentially make more donuts.
Never been too much in the whole donut area myself. It's like you buy it and you can like feel the grease coming out. It's like,
Well. I like the filled ones.
You got the same problem.
The ones that have like jam in the center, or like they have the icing, but then they got like the jam in the center, or chocolate filling. Not really donuts, then, are they? Because donuts kind of are round and have a hole in the middle. This one's like, you know, it's round, but the hole in the middle is filled with something else.
That's not a donut anymore, indeed.
What would you call it then? Pastry?
They probably have a proper name for it, depending on where it's originally produced from.
An eclair?
Aren't eclairs straight, like not round?
Okay. Just throwing names out there.
Sure, eventually one will stick.
Like, you know, caramel slice.
There you go.
Caramel slices are great. You've tried them?
I have actually no idea what you mean by it. Is it like something like toffee or?
Well, I think it's got like a bit of pastry on the bottom. It's got caramel in the middle and chocolate on the top.
Yeah, I'm not that much of a sweet tooth, actually.
Okay. I think you're supposed to make it in a huge batch and then you cut it up and then you cut it into slices, so that's why it's called a caramel slice, because big slices of a big pastry.
Well, I mean, it doesn't sound bad.
Delicious. Although, because it has chocolate and it's got caramel, best keep it refrigerated until you need it.
Uh-huh. Well, I think I got an ID out of a country, at least, on this one.
So have I, but, you know, don't think... Like, I'm keep heading forward, I'm still not seeing any obvious signs or, you know, what road this is on. I'm like, eh.
Yeah, without a road number, it's not going to get any better for me either.
So I'm just going to keep going forward until I... And admire the scenery until something happens. Like a real road trip.
Yeah, I guess you can call it that. Well, anyway, time's running out on my end.
Yep. We've got 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. It's nowhere near where we thought it was. Hey!
Did you get the country right?
Yep. Brazil.
Brazil.
Alright, ready?
Yep.
Yep. Go. Alright. This is gonna be bad.
Well, I mean, I've had a few guests and I don't think I can do any worse than I've already had. I mean, I think it was episode 37, 38. I wasn't on a road. I was in a freaking boat.
Well, you know how they say when the maps tell you, take a boat, you know, go through the water to get to this destination?
Don't they tell you to take a jet ski specifically? I think Street View does. Like, if you go from, say, Europe to America, it'll send you someplace, then take a jet ski across the ocean. It's like, yeah, that might take a while, actually. Yeah, I think it specifically says jet ski.
Your destination should be on the left.
Somewhere. Oh, it's that weird language again.
Ew. My camera just reset.
Well, you won't fool me this time.
Won't get fooled again, yeah?
I might still be, though.
Yeah, the, sorry. Yeah!
Yeah!
You can't really do it without the CSI Miami. Without
proper
the CSI
one-liner.
Miami scream.
Yeah, that's true.
Ooh, what's this? It's, ooh, okay. Well, I have a rough idea where it might be.
Same.
And that you're saying that weird language again?
Yeah,
I say it's around that area.
Yeah, so you already managed to narrow it down a bit more then.
Yeah.
Wait, you can get on this guy's yard? What the hell?
What, does the Google car get stopped there or something? Like, you know. Can I stop seeing the person in the house is like, hey, can I have a look at your car?
I've seen a few interesting ways that this game, well, not this game, but Street View used to take pictures. There's, so far I've had cars, boats, guy on foot, guy on a bike.
Apparently being a Street View driver is a, I think I've told this one before though, but like it's a, not a very glamorous position, and you get paid to drive along a short strip of road, but then that's it. You're not really hired by Google to do anything else further.
Well, I suppose if you're like a traveler or something, you're on the road constantly anyway, you may as well do that. But, you know,
the thing is, they don't do that at all. They hire locals.
Yeah, but I mean, if you're already meant to go on a long journey, you might as well do it in the Google car and get some money out of the trip as well.
Yes. You have to be in the local area.
There are just these weird little shacks all over the damn place.
They mark them out with city limit signs, with town limit signs, and then shortly after arriving, it's like, yep, you're out of the town now. What?
Total inhabitants, one.
Remember that episode of Get Smart where they taking the Orient Express and they go through several countries and it's like, you know, all right, we're passing Liechtenstein now. Take the passports, get it all stamped, and then 5 seconds later, all right, we've left Liechtenstein. You know, passports out again, take the stamps, and it's like, what took them so long? Oh, we had to redirect the cow on one of the tracks.
I mean, isn't Liechtenstein like 30 kilometers long, or something?
Something like that. Yeah, there's a cow on the track. We had to redirect. That's why it took them.
Redirect to an entirely different country.
No, as in they had to redirect the train because, you know, the trip. They entered Liechtenstein. It took them 5 seconds to go to pass through. and that took too long. That's sort of the joke.
Yeah. I'm with you on that one. I'm with you.
Although, have you seen or have you heard of the book called The Mouse That Roared?
No, I haven't.
Basically, it's one of those tiny countries. They decide that, well, their money is running low. Their only export is really expensive wine, but they're really running low on money. And they decide, well, you know what we should do? We should go to war against America, get our butts kicked, and they'll pay us reparations in huge amounts.
I think those are paid by the loser.
What I think is that America hits, you know, not like they're not going to do any damage to America, so they don't need to pay any reparations. Because what are they going to destroy? Oh, an American stubs his toe. I mean, the thing is, though, the reconstruction of the territory of the country would boost their economy.
Unless they bring it back to their original state.
Well, the thing is, it would boost their economy. So that's what they wanted to do. They wanted to go to war with America just to do that.
So the problem was things turn out.
Well, the thing is, they sent the message to the United States. The United States is like, yeah, right, whatever. Then the people from this landlocked country, you know, take a boat to America, you know, get a bunch of longbowmen, send it to America. They go to New York, and during an air raid, and like everyone's going for an air raid drill, so there's no one in New York at the current moment, or there isn't really anyone.
Okay.
So they just walk. So they walk through the empty city, and they find this scientist working on a really, really powerful bomb, and they capture him and take him back.
All right.
And it turns out that this bomb was like so powerful it could destroy the world. So all the world leaders start coming together and they start offering these guys money to you know, hold on to the bomb or to safeguard the weapon. Like, you know, America wants it back, but Russia's like, hey, I'll give you all this money. The Soviet Union's like, I'll give you all this money if you don't give it back to the Americans. We'll protect you.
Sure. Sometimes you just need to get lucky, I guess.
But the thing is, they did get lucky, but the problem is that they got a lot of money, and then the queen is like, all right, this is going on for too long. We need to do something about this because honestly, it's getting really bad. All this politicking. Then I think what happens is that then it turns out like then the scientist gets really upset and he accidentally activates the bomb, and it's a dud. But you know, world tensions are really, really high, and everyone learned an important lesson. And they got a lot of money because of all the tourism and stuff.
Great,
and, you know,
so
because Russia offered them a lot of money.
30 seconds left and I finally find the town name. Jeez.
Wow. But yes, that's why it was called The Mouse That Roared. They made a movie about it starring Peter Sellers playing as a lot of the characters.
Okay.
Playing as pretty much everyone because...
budget was a bit tight.
Well, the thing is, Peter Sellers also plays multiple characters in the same movie. Look at Dr. Strangelove. Wow.
Wow.
Our guesses are pretty much the same.
You went with Serbia as well, then.
Pretty much, because, you know, last time.
I saw a weird L again. I thought this has to be the same country. Nope.
Wait, so view summary, that's it?
Yeah, that's it.
Okay, well, you led by 3,000 points.
In total?
I think so.
Oh yeah, I got 3,000 on you. Ish.
Yeah, roughly. That was not bad. Not bad at all.
No, weird guesses, though. I mean, basically, you had like two of those Cyrillic guesses, and those are generally... The Brazilian one was pretty much a crapshoot as well.
I think my main problem was I confused the vein. Confused Quebec for France.
Yeah, that one... He didn't even go for France, but Switzerland.
Well, you know, it was not. I thought it was going to be around that area because you put it down in France, turns out in Switzerland, and it's like, ah!
I've never seen Switzerland so far, but I suppose it could happen.
Well, I've hardly seen the United States.
Anyway, Canada was pretty easy, though, because the first thing you saw was a road sign had a maple leaf flag on it.
I did not see that at all.
Anyway, I think we can cut this one here. Thank you guys for watching. Hope you're streaming this here. Feel free to support by coming, liking, and or subbing if you haven't already. Thank you, Stars of Jay, for being here and playing along with me.
No problem.
And I'll see you guys on the next episode. Bye, everyone.
See ya.